So good morning, sir. Morning. In the seventh day, when God created the heavens and earth, there's no evening and there's no morning. Seventh day is eternity. So this is the seventh day and the holy day. So we're not governed by time, so we can meet at 11 o'clock, we can meet at 1 o'clock. Okay, but if you have some problems with the time, please talk to Mike Ward. He made executive order. And if you want to change the time, please join the club so you can make it in time. 7 p.m. is okay. So anyway, let's pray. Heavenly Father, thank you for the word of God. Please grant us your word today and help us to look at you and praise you and also thank you for the life-giving word of God. I pray in Jesus' name. Amen. Okay, so this is Genesis chapter 1 and 2. There are many things that we can talk about, but I will focus on one verse. So let's look at Genesis 1:27. This is our anchor verse for the whole semester, and I hope that this can be the anchor verse for your life. That's my prayer. So let's look at the Genesis 1:27. Those who have a Bible, please share with others. And then this is a very familiar past verse. So let's commit to the memory today, okay? Let's commit to the memory. It's very easy verse. So God made man, what? In his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. Okay, I'll recite. And then, so God made man, what? In his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Male and female, he created them. Right? Okay, who memorized that? So, anybody? Any volunteers? How about Gloria? How about John Morris? Oh, this is it. This is the first you should know. Okay? I'll buy you ice cream when you memorize this. Okay, Mike. So, after Mike and Abe Song, okay?
God created man in his own image. In the divine image he created them is in my brain, but in the divine image he created them, man and woman he created them.
Okay, that's very good. How about Ibsen? The Russian guy, okay?
So God created man in his own image, in the image of God who created him, male and female created him.
Yeah. Okay, okay, that's good. How about handsome guy, 14
God created him in his own image. In his image, he created him, male and female, he created them.
Okay, that's very good. So, we are going to meditate on this word today. So God created man in his own image. In the image of God, he created them. Created him, male and female, he created them. Okay? So, here's my plan. We'll talk about three things, who God is, and then who we are, and then some implications knowing this truth. Right? So first, let me talk about God, who God is. So we have many different ideas of who God is, right? For some people, God is, what? Is it your job? They are here to get life together, you know, get a job afterward, and you know, they think they'll make happy. So people like to say, we work very hard, so God is your job. You know? And some people, God can be your children. Right? And then God is what? Something that controls you. Right? So God is ultimate reality. So we want to find out who God is. And then in the Bible, in Genesis, it declares that our God made heavens and the earth. Okay? And then, if you can ask me to prove that, then I have a hard time because I'm a chemist. What does chemist do? Chemist looking at the facts, looking at data, right? But unfortunately, I was not before the creation of the world. I cannot see how God created. So those of us with confidence can say how God created heavens and earth, raise your hand. And I'll buy you ice cream. No, because it's impossible. Because science cannot go, there's a limit, you know. So we have the fear of Big Bang, right? We can go back many, many billions of years. And then scientists say there is a singularity. Everything happened at a point, right? And then it just, the universe exploded, right? And then if you ask me how it happened, we cannot go there because somebody has to go far below, beyond time, and they tell you that how it happened. So the Bible says, clearly, God made the heavens and the earth. The fact that he can say that is, what? God was before the creation. Right? So our God is bigger than this universe because he made us. Right? So the concept of God, I don't know how big your concept of God is. When you read Genesis 1, verse 1, it just blows away. Your God is too small. We construct God in a way that we can comprehend. But God is beyond our knowledge. And if you combine all the science together, it does not, it doesn't equal to God because God is infinite. Then we have a problem. If God is so great, then how we can know God? Unless he comes to you and disclose himself who he is. So the Bible says that very confidently, the first verse of the Bible says, I made the heavens and earth with a declaration. And then Genesis 1:27 says, after he made everything, stars, animals and everything, and God declares, God made man what? In his own image. In the image of God, he made him, male and female. So, I want to talk about, based on that, then who we are. Okay, fundamentally who we are. So if I ask John the postdoc, who are you? Well, he's a man, okay? That's good. Just man? Man made in the image of God, okay? So that's who we are. So we have many ideas who we are, but that makes us equal. Man is not God. We do not make God. God made us. Let's make it very clear for you. So you are not God. Let me tell you, I'm not God. Isaac is not God. I don't care how pretty, how handsome the guy or girl looks like to you. Man is not God. Right? So it's a very different concept to understand because we think that we are God, you know, and that we think that we judge God, and that we tell God what to do, but let's make it very clear, we are not God. God made us in the image of God. What does it mean that we are made in the image of God? So, you know, this is what I think it's very simple, because suppose you want to get married, okay? So you want to get married and you want to marry a beautiful lady, and then what do? You look at that lady and you look at her mom. Pretty much, I can guarantee you, 30 years later, the lady you marry will be like her mom. image of God. Or, I don't know what Jerry's mom looks like, because his mom passed away a long time ago. But I have his father, and I have his Jerry, and I can guess how she looks like. I can have a composite picture of Jerry's mom looks like, you know, right? Because if that is the case, when the Bible says, what? God made us in the image of God, right? Then when I look at JJ, not only I can look at how his mom and father looks like, but what can I see? Yeah, that's right, the image of God, that's right. But sometimes I don't see it. Most of the time I don't see it. I just see JJ. Then what's the problem? It means that there are two ways, okay? I must be blind, okay? The Bible declares JJ is made in the image of God. I don't see it, then I'm a blind man. Or, other possibility might be, JJ is not reflecting the image of God. He's not a complete person yet. Right? So he's on the way, so he's reflecting more, but he reflects just what I don't see it. That means I have some serious problems, right? So, we are going to talk about that just at the next chapter, why we have difficulty to see that, but just look at it. That when God made us, He made us in the image of God. So when I see people, I have to see how God sees. Right? So I think that's a very important concept for us. Because without this, my life doesn't mean nothing. Why? Right? Because, you know, when I'm doing well, I can say, I made by image of God. What if I do poorly? What if I do so poorly that, you know, my wife abandoned me or something? That's worst case. But what do? I flunked out of school and I become nobody. There are many times I felt like that way. I feel like worthless. You know? It's like I the whole world crumbled down and I feel worthless. But this word of God gave me the necessary foundation, because he says, Sam, you are made in the image of God. Your intrinsic value comes from not what you have done, right? Or what kind of phone I have. Or, you know, it doesn't matter what kind of phone I have. Or what? You're made in the image of God, so you are valuable. So, when we look at people, we look at different ways, right? It's hard to understand that, but we are made, right, by God. And then our worth comes from knowing that we are made in the image of God. And this give us very necessary encouragement each day. And that means that, what does it mean that we are made in the image of God? That means, you know, of course, God is creator, right? That means what? We are very creative. Right? So we make some things try to make something out of nothing. And we have this good ideas, right? Right? And then we have this notion of complete happiness. So we are in the image of God. So I call it the whole package, okay? Right? So when you have the image of God, when you have the breath of God, then we become a living being. That means we are alive. Then what does it mean? What will make your life complete, so joyful, right? make you complete. How about you? What do you make complete?
Image of God.
Oh, image of God. What does it mean?
I gotta restore it.
What?
I have to restore it.
Oh, you have to restore it? Oh, just before that, okay, then what to you're talking in Genesis chapter 3, but let's talk about Genesis 1 and 2, okay? Alright. So when I was young, about Peter's age, okay? I had a notion of happiness. Right? Because my father ate Big Mac, right? And then he used to give me a happy meal, okay? Happy state because I went to McDonald's today. I got, oh, the smiling guy, you know. It's pretty, right? Right? And then if you look at the McDonald's, then they give you what? This hamburger, right? Are you hungry? Who didn't eat lunch yet? Don't take my happiness away, okay? I'm okay. Right? Hamburger, and then they have French fries, right? And then milk, I didn't really care about that. I was happy with this one. Toys. So my notion of happiness, right? McDonald's curry, right? Was that I have the hamburger, that means the hamburger is in my body. French fries can be my wife, salty, right? Milk can be my wife. And also, I man is a toy, okay? Right? It's very emotional, right? So this was my happiness. And then I realized later, man, this is after a chocolate food. Right? It doesn't give you, try to live out the happy meal every day, okay? And then your life will be, your expectancy will go down, basically. Even though, McDonald promises happy meal is not a happy meal. But what the Genesis chapter 1 to talk about? What's the image of God? The whole package. So I want to look at briefly what the package what is, right? I think the first is number one. Genesis chapter 1 and 1 says, God made heavens and earth. This knowledge. That we are not God. We are God's creature. Right? It's one of the things that we need. Right? And that's number one. And Genesis 2:2. What's that? What will make us happy? Genesis chapter 2:2 is what? He rested. God refreshes us. God gives us rest. God really, you know, refresh our heart and mind so they can rest peacefully and sleep well. And there's another is Genesis chapter 2:15. What's Genesis chapter 2:15? Anybody can read the 2:15? says, the Lord God took the man and put him in the Garden of Eden to work it and take care of it. In order to be a whole package, you need work. Not just any kind of work, like working at the pharmacy or something like that, or McDonald's, you need meaningful work that you can take care of God's garden, that you and God working together, taking care of this garden. And by garden means that it's planned and make it beautiful. Meaningful work. It's very important. Okay? So, and try to do work in a messy apartment, okay? Some people try it, right? So, you know, I like the movie Beautiful Mind. This guy has a beautiful mind, but when he look at his, somebody look at his room, so messy. Do you think that his creative mind will do the flow? No, I don't think so. to release that kind of beauty, that, you know, that environment so we can really flourish, okay? The God is that. And then there is God gave him the word of God in Genesis chapter 2, 16, 17. So God makes it clear. There are some things you should do, some things you should not do. And there's a severe consequence. You do this, you die. That means God wants to establish that you are not God. I made it. You don't try to be happy, you have to obey God. So that's word of God makes us one of the components. And then think about that. What's the last component? Last component, okay? This guy has a nice garden, nice apartment, clean, spotless, well organized, and this guy has a nice job, right? And everything is beautiful, and he has a meaningful life. But when God looked at man, something was not right. What was that? Here comes my favorite verse, okay? 2:18, the Lord God said, "It is not good for a man to be alone. I'll make a helper suitable for him." Then what does it mean? Actually, it's talking about man, okay? So ladies, so I just you don't have to listen to me. But for man, man is like a happy meal with a french fries missing, okay? Right? Man is not complete. And man is helpless because man needs helper. And the ladies has to help us. Because man is stupid. And then you smile at them, they think, oh, they like you, and then, you know, oh, there's something going on. But nothing going on, okay, ladies, gentlemen, please. Nothing going on, okay? They're just smiling. They just look pretty, but nothing was going on, okay? So, because there's some communication problem, manager comes from communication problem, because one of my roommates, you know, he went to the library, and he sat there, and there's a lady sitting across the table, and then she smiled at him. So he was so happy. He came to me, oh, this girl likes me. And then, but she forgot to wear glasses, okay? That day, you know, she was smiling and looking at the literature, and she was, you know, looking at the book, and she was smiling. And then she got the wrong impression, okay? So man is like that. Clueless, absolutely clueless. And then God sees man, and God sees what? His needs, right? So that we thank God because God knows us, and God made us, and God knows what you need. And then God does something to make us man happy. So he brings out this woman. And I say, wow, man. And then they become united. And then they were complete naked, but they felt no shame. Right. So when is the last time you felt completely naked and felt no shame? You can be open to really authentic. You can open anything to you. That's the one God created us to be. We can be authentic, and we know, and we can be accepted completely, and there's no shame. And I think this is a complete package. That's the one that God intended us to make. Right? So when I look at the pray about this semester, and then let me talk about the implications of this knowledge. Given this knowledge, okay, that we believe that God made us in the image of God. God is the creator. We are not the creator. We are just creatures. But we have the glory of God, the image of God. Right? And what does it mean? What does it mean personally and as a collectively? So given this knowledge, I want to make several implications, and I need your prayers, okay? Because when people look at me, ideally, they have to see me, okay? You know, I'm a first man made by God. Right? It's very easy to see. Because I seems like I have the whole package, okay? Right? Handsome. Intelligent. Some are sloppy. No? But beyond that, what they have to see me? On the surface, they have to see the image of God. And I have to reflect the image of Jesus. And then, well, that's hard. Because usually, when people see me, they see sometimes handsome face, but sometimes irritable face, sometimes anxious mind, sometimes busy mind, and I don't reflect God. You know, that means I can say, oh, that guy is blind. Or I can say, I don't reflect God's image. So, and when we look at people, how do you see it? How do you see it? And then the complete loser comes to you, and then look at me, and then what do you do? You judge by people by how they dress. What kind of car they drive. Or what kind of job they have. Whether he smells nice or not. It's a very difficult question to imply because as a community, we have to reflect God's image, and then we fail many times because we do not see the image of God, or we fail to reflect it. So I think we have to really thank God because I think this is one of the most important verses in the Bible. So God created man in the image, in his own image. Male and female, he created them. So in God, there is not a male is better than female. They both reflect. They both need. They have to have a unity and union so that they can reflect the glory of our Creator. So one of the things that we have to do is that let's pray that this semester, let's ask God that he can open our eyes to see. You know, we need help because even though I wear my glasses, I cannot see well. The first thing is that we have to thank God for the life-giving word of God. Because without this word of God, human life means nothing. Your life is only $2, you know, in chemical terms, okay? Right? It's here, he's here today, gone tomorrow. Nobody cares about you. Nobody will make a history, okay? Except you kill a lot of people. But to God's eyes, he's confident. I made you. I know how you should be. I have God's glory. You have God's glory. And then we see it, okay? Not only this lady singing, we don't see it just as my marriage candidate. No, you see it, the glory of Jesus, no? Wow, God made. And then, wow, I'm so happy that she's singing because she's singing the praise of God. And then when you see that somebody studying, I say, oh, wow, okay. He really wants to figure out how God made, you know, heavens and earth. So we are not surprised by science. We are not surprised by pretty girls. We are not surprised by our hormonal instinct.